Baby, you find there's only one love, yours and mine. I've got so much love and needing you so. My love for you, I'll never let go. I've got so much love.
All right, give it up for him, ladies and gentlemen.
We really appreciate the fact that you guys traveled to celebrate this momentous occasion with us tonight. And I'd also like to give a special thanks to David and Jean, Connor's mom and dad. They threw a wonderful rehearsal dinner last night, and it was fantastic. And at the end of that rehearsal dinner, they gave us a slideshow, and in that slideshow were a number of pictures of Connor growing up and Claire growing up, and it was like, wow, you know, these pictures are so awesome. I remember everything that happened to Claire, and when a father knows he's got to do a toast, he starts thinking about what he's going to talk about. And so I started thinking about what I was going to say tonight, and I started jotting down a number of things I was going to say. And last night, I saw the pictures of all these events kind of scroll through that I'm going to talk about tonight. So I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about Claire Lisbeth and some things that we experienced with her as she was growing up. So as many of y'all know, Claire Lisbeth is our second child of four, right? And when she was born, we were just absolutely thrilled to have a baby girl. She has been a very special part of our lives for 26 years. And you know what? What I can say about Claire Lisbeth is that throughout her childhood, she was a very happy child. She was very, she smiled a lot. But most importantly, she was a very independent child. She liked to do things her way. And so, I'm going to share with you guys some things that in her childhood that, you know, have been very memorable to me. So when she was a little girl, it was one Christmas, and I can't remember how old you were, but you got an American Girl doll for Christmas, right? And her doll's name was Josefina. And she carried Josefina with her pretty much everywhere she went. And she liked to dress this doll, she liked to play with this doll, but most importantly, she liked to brush this doll's hair.
Oh no.
And this doll's hair became this tangled mess. It was matted, I mean, it was just horrible, right? But she continued to play with this doll, and she played with this doll a long time. Right? And so she just loved dressing her up and taking care of her. And she did that, you know, just over and over. And Claire, that must be why you are so good with kids, because they absolutely love you to death. Huh? And it's all because of Josefina. Now, Connor, I'm going to tell you something. The last trip that Claire took to see her dance coach, she took Josefina with her. Right? And dropped her off at the American Doll store there in Raleigh, right? Doll Hospital. And so Josefina is in brand spanking new shape right now. And she's coming to your house.
She's getting a China cabinet.
Okay, so where else? What else can I talk about here? Like all the kids in our family, there were a lot of activities, right? But for Claire, her passion was always, you want to tell me what it is?
Dancing.
That's exactly right. And it didn't matter whether it was ballet or ballroom. She wanted to be the best she could be. And so she spent countless hours in the dance studio getting ready for whether it was ballet performances or it was dance competitions. And it really paid off for her in her ballroom dance, because she traveled, she competed, and she won multiple awards dancing. She is an awesome dancer, and she is a whole lot better than me. And so she's just phenomenal at that, and I'm very proud of her for that. So in college, Claire Elizabeth majored in Spanish and international business. And as a part of her studies, she got the privilege to spend 8 weeks in Barcelona. That's a dad's worst nightmare. I had to take her to the airport in Atlanta with her mother. We took her over there, and I had to put my daughter on an airplane going to Barcelona, Spain for 8 weeks. And so what do dads do? I stayed up all night watching FlightAware to make sure that she made it to Barcelona. And so she got there, and she got with her host family, and she'd been there for a couple of weeks, and got a phone call, and she says, "I'm going to Rome." I said, "You're going where?" But now she went over, and so you saw the pictures last night. She had a picture made in Barcelona there on the heights, and a picture in front of the Colosseum. And the happiest day, one of the happiest days of my life, was after that 8 weeks was up and I was able to go to Atlanta and pick her up at the airport. I was so glad that she was home. So what does that mean? That means that you and Connor are going to have multiple travel adventures in your life. And I can't wait to hear where you guys go and what you guys see. Okay. And I mentioned earlier before that one of my favorite things about Claire is, one of the things about Claire is, she has an independent streak. So when she sets a goal for herself, she pursues that goal with all her heart. All right? So when she decided to go to graduate school, what did she do? She started looking at all the different degrees that she could look at or possibly go for, and all the different programs across the nation. And she came in one day and she said, "I think I'm going to do cybersecurity." And so she picked a program at Georgia State, and she actually finished that program in a year. And so, you know, Claire Elizabeth, all I can say is you are the most confident, professional, and beautiful girl I've seen in a long time. And we are very, very proud of you. So David and Jean, where are you guys at? There you are. I want to thank you guys for raising such a wonderful young man, and all I can say is, Connor, you're an absolute gentleman, okay? And, you know, I noticed that the first time I met you, and when Claire Elizabeth told me that you were coming over to the house for the first time, now you remember that night, she said, "Dad, I think you're going to like him. He's a lot like you." And I have to say, we do have very much the same sense of humor, yeah. Right? And so I think very highly of your son, very much so. And I couldn't think of a better match for Claire Elizabeth than Connor. And so tonight is very special for me. So we're looking forward to getting to know you better, as well as your family better. And it's just been awesome. And so I can't say anything else about that. So, Connor, I congratulate you and Claire. My only request is that you continue to love her with all your heart. There will be good times. There may be some not so good times. But in the end, it's the road you're going to travel, and this is going to be your journey. Right? So everyone here, I'm going to give a toast. I want everybody to please stand and raise your glass with me if I can read this. I know you will love and cherish each other every bit as much as Stephanie and I love ourselves, love one another. And I want you guys to be successful in your life. So I offer you a toast to happiness, a healthy life, full of joy, endless love, and laughter. This is for y'all.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here today to celebrate Claire and Connor. I'm Sarah Grace. I'm Claire's sister. I got married last year, and Claire gave a speech, and now it's my turn to do the same for her. When we were younger, we were into all of the same things. Dance, American Girl dolls, Barbie, you name it. We did it together. As all of you with siblings know, eventually you grow up and grow apart. Instead of doing everything together, I leaned more into sports and theater, and Claire became a competitive ballroom dancer. And if you've never seen her dance before, you have missed out because she is good. And I mean really good, okay? I would consider Claire and I to be a pair of those siblings who are lucky, though. Instead of going to college and making new friends and distancing ourselves, we grew closer in college. I remember leaving birthday presents and posters on the door of her dorm room at 1 o'clock in the morning for her birthday. And I remember going to a late night breakfast together my freshman year when I didn't really know anybody. I have gotten to watch her turn into an amazing person who cares for other people in a way I haven't seen a lot of people do. She's someone who is funny and easy to laugh with, and someone I can send sassy Elmo memes to. I know I can tell her anything, and even if it comes with the look, which if you've gotten the look before, you know. I know it really means that she cares and wants the best for me. Connor Brown. It's always Connor Brown. It's never been just Connor. It's always Connor Brown. I have enjoyed getting to know you over the past several months. When I look at you, I can see the love that you have for my sister. You really get her and understand who she is. Since the two of you have been together, I have watched her grow into a much happier person, and happy in a way that I have not seen her in a very, very long time. And with the way y'all look at each other, it's a sign of two people who I know who are perfect for each other. I can't imagine Claire with anyone else, and I hope you know how special of a person she is and continue to treat her as such. So, Claire, even though we don't have the same name anymore, our husbands do, and that's kind of the same thing. So this is to Claire and Connor. May the two of you continue to love each other and grow in your love, and may you have an abundance of happiness in your life together.
I'm going to keep this kind of short because there's no way that you can easily sum up 20 years of friendship in a talk like this. I have known the Shepherds since my family moved across the street from them when Claire and I were 7, 8 years old. And we have been close ever since then. I cannot tell you how many nights we have spent at sleepovers, watching Barbie movies, playing with My Little Ponies, watching The Real Teen Titans. All of it. And yeah, that's how we learned about the world. That's how we learned about each other. That's how we learned about the Lord and the people that He wanted us to become. And every moment has been so beautiful knowing Claire and her family. Like, it's such a gift. And so I knew when Claire and I started talking about Connor more and more, and when the two of them started dating, he and I were gonna have to talk. So when he came to Washington, D.C., I appreciated it, being able to have dinner with him for the first time. And my boyfriend, Andrew, asked me then, you know, what are you doing? I was telling him, you know, oh, I'm going to interrogate this man. I'm going to grill him. He's not going to know what hit him. But as soon as we, even before we sat down, I started to get a sense of the type of person that Connor is. He's a God-fearing man. He's honest. He's intentional. And I could not ask for a better man for my best friend. And so I am just so grateful that you guys have found the person to really complete you, to make you whole, and to build you up. And so, yeah, this toast is for the two of you. May the Lord bless you and keep you for all of your days.
Hi, everyone. My name's Blake. I'm Connor's brother. He's unfortunately known me for a whole 25 years. He's been putting up with me. And vice versa. All right. Typically, when people give a wedding speech, they expect you to talk about the memories. And as much as I'm sure you would all love for me to talk about the time Connor and I color all over the carpet with rose art markers, or when I accidentally stabbed him in the eye with a screwdriver, I decided to take a bit of a different approach and talk about some of Connor's favorite things in life. So Connor likes a bit of spice in his life. You could say Claire could potentially be that as well, but so much so that he had to tell us to stop buying him hot sauce and spicy things for Christmas. And literally 1 week ago when I was over at his house, he showed me his hot sauce cabinet in his kitchen, and he literally has a whole shelf full of it. So if you ask him nicely, it's very possible he'll give you a bottle because acid reflux is no joke. And growing up, speaking of food, I always thought Connor was a bit more of a picky eater, but over the past few years, he's branched out a little bit. So much that even our entire family is a bit surprised with his new culinary tastes. The first time that I heard Connor mention Thai food, I was genuinely surprised because he was definitely a chicken nuggets and french fries kind of kid growing up. And now it's like really weird. I'll be like, oh yeah, I have to go to this city for work. It's like, oh, there's a Thai place here. How did you know that? You've never even heard of this small town before. But he knows about all of the good places. So if you need good food recommendations, once again, ask him nicely. I'm sure he'll be happy to give you recommendations. Connor is also an active individual. For years, his sport was basketball for many years. And then in college, that became ultimate frisbee. And now is disc golf, which I learned yesterday playing with him, I'm not very good at. And he even does the occasional hike as well, which I personally don't get. I don't like a good bug bite or anything. But turns out that Connor's really passionate about having that activity. And last week he was telling me all about his disc golf and what all of the numbers mean and the different weight and the spin. Honestly, I studied social science, y'all. I didn't do engineering. I don't understand how all that works, but it was really interesting at least getting to see him being really excited about it, because that's a side of Connor that I didn't get to see for a while. And who knows, maybe he'll eventually take up ballroom dancing.
Yes, he will.
Especially growing up in our house, Connor is really good at trivia as well. And Connor and I really make a good team because he helps handle the sports and geography questions and classic rock. Well, I can do a little bit more of the entertainment and pop culture questions, but I've still got you beat on SpongeBob trivia. You're not winning that battle. And Connor also likes the occasional eclectic thing that you might find unexpected, such as his rose bushes that he inherited when he bought his house, or a creepy squirrel hand puppet that he won at a gag gift Christmas party, or even a few Celine Dion CDs that he bought at the thrift store that you might not know he's a secret fan of her. And although he's not a Swiftie yet, Claire and I are gonna work on that together. So all of that to say, when I was writing the speech, speaking about all of these things helped me realize that there's this adventurous spirit within Connor that I never really realized until recently. And the first time I met Claire, I noticed that immediately. They're just expressed in different ways. And realizing that about you, Connor, helped me realize that both of those adventurous personalities that you have, like I said, are expressed in different ways, but I know that together you're going to challenge each other in a good way. And I'm just really excited to see, what's in store for your life. I think we all are, and how you guys are going to continue to challenge each other. And yeah, I forgot a drink, so I can't do a cheers, but cheers to that.
Thank you.